top hat, 62nd bed. Top hat, 32nd bed. We'll be right back.
little stiff, like something on his back, almost. Got a mustache. Looked like a grateful dead dog, and helped him grow up.
I Yeah, just so he can put it on the below, yeah.
Okay, Philip Smerek with two L's, and the last name is S-M-E-R-E-K. I hope you know how to spell Philip.
It's Craig Ortworth, O-R-T-W-E-R-T-H, a political science major.
Either.
I think it's Wayne.
I'll call you.
Well, they say games are won in the trenches, and that's where the Bulldogs were strong against Evansville. Joining me is senior offensive tackle Phil Smerek and senior defensive end Craig Ortworth. And Phil, I'll start with you. I know you guys really wanted to get the running game going this afternoon, and that's what you did. You came out and really took it to them.
Yeah, we had a good plan this week. We had double teams on two people at least on the line, so we were able to get real good movement up front. And our basic plan was get drive out 5-yard runs and just keep consistent with those two double teams, and we did a great job at it. And this week, probably in all the weeks that we've had, was the best that our whole offensive line and offense came together and did a great job, and we put it up. We had a little trouble at the beginning punching in the end zone, but as soon as we got calm, we were able to do it. And we basically, we got 3 points off the two drives, but we were able to roll after that.
You know, you talk about developing some confidence, and you guys started picking up those third down and ones, fourth down and ones in the second half, even though Evansville knew the run was coming, and I think that really shows that this line's developing, isn't it?
Yeah, that's really key. On the first two plays, you know, you might have 8-9 yards, but that third down is most key, and they know it's coming, and they know it's run, so you just got to bear down and make sure you get. And we had a great job by Charlie Schimberg. He was just putting his shoulders down. We were picking up that 1 to 2 yards that we needed, and it was just great. It was just showing how our offensive line was coming back together.
And then it also sets up the bootlegs. I know that hurt them a few times with Roy getting to the outside.
Yeah, on the short downs, we were seeing that they weren't covering Roy. They just thought we were going to run the ball, and that opened up Roy on a few of those bootlegs, and they just worked like a charm. He had, I think, 2 or 3 for at least 15 yards, and that was just, it was great. They couldn't cover all of us, so we were just able to do it.
Well, I'll turn to Craig Ortworth now, and I guess it's only fitting you're up here with Phil because you said you guys are roommates, right?
Yep. We lifted partners in the summer, and we live together in the same house this year.
Well, the defensive line, let's talk a little bit about that. I know you wanted to get the pressure on Eric Fish with just 4 down linemen. You guys were able to do that. I know you watched on film and saw that you could get to him, couldn't you?
Yeah, you know, Dayton did a heck of a job getting 4-man pressure, and that led to their, you know, beating Evansville. And we thought, you know, we're as good as Dayton, if not better. And, you know, we thought we could come out and get 4-man pressure. You have to get 4-man pressure against Evansville, and we did a good job.
Talk a little bit about the cat and mouse game. I know you know, we see a lot of speed rushes from you, but you also have to vary that, don't you? You have to come underneath and really don't show the tackle the same rush each time, do you?
Yeah, you know, you try to beat him with speed early in the game, and that way you can get it in his head that you can beat him, and then when you give him the inside moves or the outside spins, that way he has to keep conscious of all three. He can't key on one thing.
Talk a little bit about the fumble late in the first half. It set up a touchdown. It looked like you stripped the football and Charlie Partridge came up with it.
You know, Coach Anderson really drills us on when you're coming from the backside, and, you know, the quarterback's not looking at you, to try to get your hand on the ball because he's not, you know, he's getting ready to throw. And I just got lucky enough to get it out.
This was a big win for you guys. It keeps you in title contention. You come back after a loss to Butler, and it was a great win for you.
Yeah, you know, in the 3 years since you know, we've been up playing against these guys, we've never lost 2 in a row. And so it was a big game for us to win. And especially since we lost last week against a conference foe, we had to come back and get a victory. You know, we're still back. We're still in the hunt, and we're ready for Valpo now.
And the Bulldogs strong in the trenches in two of the regions, Phil Smerek and Craig Ortworth.